Your mental state is like a musical instrument, with the environment playing with your mind. From the moment you wake up, your subconscious is manipulated by a barrage of different sights, sensations, sounds, and scents without you consciously realizing it. Music is a powerful stimulus. Tempo, for example, can manipulate your heartbeat, brainwaves, strength, and even perceived passage of time. Due to the accessibility of music through the internet, most establishments play music in order to enhance the atmosphere of the space, be it Ed Sheeran or the same Christmas songs on repeat that slowly degrades your life essence. This background music serves a deeper purpose, however. This is how music makes you spend more. The impact of music on our habits goes beyond simply manipulating our mood. This landmark study by Milliman shows the powerful impact that tempo has. By measuring how much time and money shoppers spend in a supermarket when slow and fast-paced instrumental music was played, they found that slow music significantly increased revenue by roughly $5,000 or 38.2% in comparison to fast music and no music. Different tempos may affect our time perception in unique ways, so that slow music makes us perceive time slower. This may be the result of external tempos affecting our theoretical biological clock, which speeds up and slows down in response to arousal. This results in slower walking pace and increases time spent in the shop, making it more likely that you'll spend more money buying stuff. So, in many ways, the tempo of music acts like a human pacemaker. In addition to tempo, volume may also affect us. In the case of cafes, music at a sufficient loudness can make you stay longer by blocking out background noise and to give the illusion that the space is filled. However, if the music is too loud, it can act as an unpleasant stimulus, deterring people, much like noisy neighbours or the constant barking of dogs. So volume is very much like a double-edged sword that can be used to control how many people are in a space. On the other hand, specific genres of music may also have a significant impact on our behaviour. Researchers found that when classical music was played in a restaurant, spending per person increased by roughly £3 in comparison to pop music and no music at all. This means that if 60 people on average ate in a restaurant each day for an entire week, excluding Sundays, then a restaurant could potentially profit roughly $1,000 just from playing Mozart. Other researchers found similar results playing classical music in a wine cellar, which resulted in patrons spending an additional $5 choosing more expensive wines. Classical music may promote a more upmarket atmosphere, which results in more exuberant spending. Another reason could be that classical music simply attracts specific types of people who are more willing to spend more. These studies show the interesting cultural impact on how music shapes our behaviour. If classical music didn't have a posh, upmarket feel, would it have the same effect? One thing these studies fail to consider, however, is that it's pretty much commonplace to use headphones everywhere today, thanks to Bluetooth, mobile phones, and the internet. If you want to negate the effects background music has on subconsciously altering your spending habits, you could in theory just use headphones. This would befit a supermarket or store setting, although probably not a restaurant or wine cellar. By listening to high tempo music, you could increase your walking pace, making you spend less. Fast-paced heavy metal music, for example, may be the perfect tool to save you money. Points being though, your subconscious is more susceptible to manipulation than you may realise. Background music serves as a powerful cognitive manipulator in an environment already tailored to enhance consumer behaviour that owners use to make you spend more and stay longer. But through using headphones, listening to the right music, and simply being more aware of the ways music affects us, you can gain more control over your subconscious behaviour and ultimately your spending habits. Thanks for watching.